In this video, we will walk through building a DirectCommand L2 configuration on the InCommand display. Building configurations correctly is important as many sprayer settings are linked to them. This allows operators to switch between different operations without having to re-enter settings each time. For this example, we'll build a configuration for a Case Patriot 4420 with a 90-foot boom on 20-inch nozzle spacing and 54 nozzles. To begin, tap the application app on the home screen. Tap the green plus to begin building a new configuration. Tap the green plus to begin creating a new vehicle. Select self-propelled applicator from the vehicle type dropdown. Then select the make and model of the machine. If the applicator has all-wheel steering, check the box. This machine does not, so we'll leave it unchecked and tap the next arrow. Tap the green plus to add an application channel to the configuration. Tap the green plus to create a new application rate controller. Select DirectCommand as the device and DirectCommand L2 as the direct type. Since we are on a sprayer, we'll leave the NH3 application checkbox unchecked. Tap the next arrow. Enter the flow meter calibration number off of the tag of the flow meter. These can be entered by tapping the plus and minus buttons, or tapping the number in the middle will bring up the number keypad. This machine has a calibration number of 71 pulses per gallon. This machine does not have a second flow meter, so we'll leave the flow meter 2 calibration at 0 and tap the next arrow. Next, we'll need to enter a controller name. If you have more than one liquid application controller on the farm, you'll need to make it specific to this machine. For this example, we'll leave it with the default name and tap the green check. Ensure the new controller we just created is selected in the dropdown and tap the next arrow. Next, we'll enter the container capacity. This machine has a 1,200 gallon capacity. Tap the next arrow. Now, we'll need to enter the number of nozzles and nozzle spacing. This machine has 54 nozzles on 20-inch spacing. Since we are not using a nozzle-by-nozzle system, we'll not check the right spot checkbox. Tap the next arrow. Next, we need to enter the number of boom section valves that are on the machine. This sprayer has 9 boom section valves. Tap the next arrow. We need to tell the sprayer how many nozzles are on each boom section valve. By default, the display divides them equally between the sections. To edit the number of nozzles on a section valve, tap the section you'd like to change, then tap the calculator icon on the right. Tap the next arrow. The section valves on this sprayer require 12-volt signal to turn on and are a standard on-off valve type. Verify the signal is set to 12-volt high and the valve type is set to standard, then tap the next arrow. Now, we'll need to measure the distance from the rear axle to the application point. This machine is 7 feet from the rear axle to the nozzles on the boom. Tap the green check to complete adding the application channel. Tap the next arrow to add any additional devices. This machine does not have any of the additional devices. We'll leave them unchecked and tap the next arrow. Now, we'll need to measure the antenna offsets as pictured. Tap each graphic to enter the offset. Once the offsets are entered, tap the next arrow. Then, we'll need to name the vehicle. If there are multiple machines on the operation of this same make and model, it will need to be made specific to this machine. For this example, we'll use the default and tap the green check to complete the vehicle setup. Verify the new vehicle we just created is selected in the dropdown and tap the next arrow. Verify the primary speed source is set to display GPS and tap the next arrow. Enter a name for this configuration. For this example, we'll use the default, which is the vehicle name, and tap the green check. Tap the green check to exit the configuration setup. Now, you will be able to build a DirectCommand L2 configuration in the InCommand display. For more information on the setup and settings for DirectCommand L2, please refer to the feature user guide on the Ag Leader Knowledgebase. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from Ag Leader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.